Hello and welcome back to wireless communication lecture series. In this video lecture you are going to learn about prioritizing handoffs, umbrella cell approach, cell dragging and a microcell zone concept. I have mentioned a timestamp in the description. If you have an interest in any of this topic, you can directly click on the timestamp and you can start learning. So let's start with prioritizing handoffs. We can do a prioritizing handoff in a two way. First, a guard channel concept, and another one is a queuing of handoff. So let us see a guard channel concept. In a guard channel concept, a fraction of total available radio channels in a cell is reserved exclusively for handoff request from ongoing calls which may be handed off into the cell. So let's consider that we have this fraction of channel available with cell. Now out of this available channel, let's consider that we have 10 number of channel available, and out of this available channel I will reserve some channels for the handoff. Let's say I am reserving a 3 channel for the handoff and 7 channel for the traffic, that can be a call or any other data traffic. So now what will happen, that we have dedicatedly allocate this 3 channel for the handoff request, and that is what we call as a guard channel concept. So if you will assign this fixed number of channel, then of course you can understand that our carried traffic will reduce. Instead of having a capacity of 10, now we have reduced to the capacity of 7. So one disadvantage of this concept is that our carried traffic in a particular cell will reduce. However, if you will applying a dynamic channel assignment strategy, that means instead of using a fixed number of channel over here, we can use a dynamic channel assignment strategy and we can get some efficient spectrum utilization, and that can be converted into advantage of this guard channel concept. As I told you, the disadvantages of this particular method is reducing the total carried traffic, and it is due to the guard channel or extra particular channel that we are providing to the handoff request. Now another prioritizing handoff method is queuing of handoff request. So queuing is actually possible due to the fact that there is a finite time interval between the time the received signal level drop below the handoff threshold and the time the call is terminated due to the insufficient signal level. So whenever a user is moving from one cell to another cell, so there is some finite interval of time that the user's signal strength will reduce to below the minimum acceptable signal. So we are taking the advantage of this particular time interval and we are putting the user into queue, and whenever the channel will be available, we will assign that particular channel to the user. So this is how queuing is working. And of course there is a trade-off between the decrease in the probability of forced termination and the total carried traffic. So in this queuing method, instead of utilizing some fixed portion for handoff, we are utilizing full available channels for the carried traffic as well as for handoff. So if any channel is available, we are using for the carried traffic as well as for the handoff also. So the advantages of this particular method is that the efficient spectrum utilization, because we are allocating a full channel to the carried traffic, so we are saying that it is an efficient spectrum utilization. But however, let's say if all channel are busy, so in that particular case there is an increase in new call blocking probability, because the total number of channel is used by the carried traffic as well as handoff also. So this may be the disadvantage of the queuing handoff request. Next, we have an umbrella cell approach, which is basically a practical handoff consideration. So here you can see that a diagram of umbrella cell concept, and it is basically for the high speed user. Now, if there is some high speed user, let's say at highway, or a person in a train is moving from one cell to another cell, let's say user is moving from here, and just forget about this blue color umbrella cell right now. And if user is moving at very high speed from one end to another end, so you can understand that within a few second or few minute, there will be a lots of handoff. Here you can see that at least there will be a 3 handoff from one cell to another cell, and that will increase the burden on the base station as well as the MSC. So for a high speed user, we have some practical solution, that is with the help of umbrella cell. Now what we will do in this system, we will put a one large cell with a high power transmitting antenna, and that we call as an umbrella cell for a high speed traffic. So now whenever user with a high speed will move within this region, the user will get a signal from the particular this large cell and not from this micro cell. So that is what we call as a umbrella cell approach. And if any pedestrian user is moving within this area, then by some sophisticated algorithm, the user will be allocated a signal from the small cell, and which we are calling as a small micro cell for the low speed traffic. So this is basically umbrella cell approach. By using a different antenna heights and different power levels, it is possible to provide large and small cell which are co-located in a single cell. This technique is called as an umbrella cell approach, and it is used to provide large area coverage to a high speed user while providing a small area coverage to a user traveling at a low speed. So this is the concept of umbrella cell approach. Another handoff practical consideration is cell tracking, which is a problem occurring in a cellular system. So cell tracking result from pedestrian users that provide very strong signal to the base station. Let us understand this concept with the help of this figure. Let's say here we have a base station, and here we have one user which is moving away from this particular cell. Now if there is some line of sight exists between the base station and the user, so here line of sight means there is no obstacle between the base station and the user. So in this case, the what will happen? The user will get the strongest signal. And as user is a pedestrian user, the user will move with a very low speed. Even if the user will be away from the or outside the base station, the user will get the very strongest signal from the base station, and this will create an traffic management and interference issue, and this issue is known as a cell dragging. So to solve the cell dragging problem, the handoff threshold and the radio coverage parameter must be adjusted carefully. So with the help of proper handoff threshold, we can solve this cell dragging issue. Another practical solution for handoff is a microcell zone concept. So actually, due to the sectoring, the cell is divided into number of parts, and due to this sectoring concept, there will be an increased number of handoff in the system, and which will create a lots of load on the mobile station as well as on the MSC. So microcell zone concept is provided by the Lee. In the microcell zone concept, the particular region is divided into three different zones. So here you can see that this is particularly considered as a one zone, and similarly we have another two zone. And this three zone will have a individual transmitter and receiver, and that will be connected to the zone selector via microwave or fiber optic link. This all three zones are connected to base station. So you can understand that this whole region is covered by only a single base station, and due to which whenever user will move from one zone to another zone, we do not require to change any channel, or we do not require the handoff. And that's how, with the help of microzone concept, we are reducing the number of handover. So you can understand that there are multiple zones and a single base station. And when a mobile travels from one zone to another cell, it retains the same channel, because we are just providing a different transmitter and receiver at different location, but with the help of same channel from the base station. So microcell zone concept is basically a method to reduce the number of handoff, and it is useful in the highway areas. Apart from this, there is one more advantage of microcell zone concept. That is, the advantage of microcell zone concept is that while the cell maintain a particular coverage radius, the co-channel interference in the cellular system is reduced, since the large central base station is replaced by the several low power transmitter on the edge of the cell. So you can see in the previous figure also, and even here also, that these are the cell we have, and now in each and every cell we have the transmitter and receiver at the edge of this particular region, and that will be even directed towards the inside the cell. So you can understand that the distance between the co-cells will be reduced, and even the power that is between the co-cell will also reduce. So this is how microcell zone concept is also reducing the co-channel interference. So this is all about all these four concepts. I hope you have understood this concept very clearly. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to subscribe this channel.